Let's get salty!
Everyone, Zeddy here again today with a brand new video. And today, Fractured Alterac Valley goes live. We will be streaming it live at launch at 10 a.m. PST, 1 p.m. EST. So if you want to head over to twitch.tv/Zeddy, could come hang out with me and my crazy chat and all that. And we'll be playing pretty much all of these decks. I plan on doing a 10-deck roulette of these decks, and then we'll maybe try other stuff that's probably actually good, because this is all theory craft stuff. It usually doesn't work out. But I'll be trying all this cool stuff out, and, well, we're going to go over what these decks are and what you know, if you open some of these cards, you can try these decks out. Again, I am not recommending crafting anything out of the gate. I never recommend crafting anything day one. Just open whatever packs you can, make whatever decks you can. If you can make one of these and try it out, go for it, but don't go out of your way for crafting. Nobody knows what the best stuff is straight out the gate, so wait on that, but at least it's something to try. And all these decks are taken, by the way, from Vicious Syndicate. They put out an article of like 30 different decks to try out. I picked one from each class that I wanted to give a go, so I'll drop the link below to their article if you want to check out some more of their stuff. Lots of stuff there. I remember last expansion, I also took their decks and they were basically all terrible, but I had some fun trying some stuff out, so we're going to do that again. So let's go through 10 decks that I could recommend at least trying out for Fractured Alterac Valley. Who knows if they'll be any good. So first, we have Token Demon Hunter. It's like the token deck built around the new hero card Kurtress, and you have your OTK in here with Expendable Performers and Fellfire Deadeye, where you can refresh your hero power a bunch of times for zero mana and do some really good stuff. You have the new Giant, Urzul Giant, which you can slam down if you've had enough tokens die. And yeah, you just got some good stuff in here, and overall it looks pretty fun. You got the whole token package, you got the objectives, a lot of new cards in this deck. So if you want to try out some Demon Hunter with Kurtress, this might be a good way to go. We have a deck that wants to cheat all the mana. I'm calling it all the mana. It's Guff Alignment Druid, where you can guff into alignment, and then your hero power, when you can spend two on it, effectively gets you a free mana ramp every single turn. You can combo with you got Anaconjure in here, Germination. We got the Pride Seeker and Pathmaker cards to kind of one play you can do, I believe, is you can play the card that cheats out your next choose one card. You can play alignment. Once you play alignment, your nourish should cost zero, ramp up and go off. So there are some love implications, and this deck isn't super new. It looks very similar to a lot of alignment druids, but it looks like it could be pretty fun, and I just want to play Guff. I want to have 20 mana and do all the things, and Guff might allow me to do that. Next, we have Big Beast Hunter. This deck actually looks terrible, but I'm gonna try it. It's built around King Crush Lerox combo. You also have the new Mountain Bear card in there to try and keep you alive. Gives you a bunch of taunts, and of course you have the new hero card in Beast Stalker Tavish. By the way, I'm pretty sure all my lists here highlight the new hero cards for each deck, because you're gonna want to play the new hero cards, right? So yeah, it's all about getting your beast from in hand and OTKing with King Crush. You got Select a Breeder in there. You got Revive Pet that can bring back your beast, as well as the secret package, a bunch of the secrets to thin your deck, cheat some mana. And I expect this deck to be absolutely terrible, but we're gonna give it a try, at least for a couple of games. And next we have Big Ping Mage. This deck actually looks like it could be okay. It looks pretty fun. It's one of the more stronger ones on theory, in theory at least here. It's got the Wildfire hero power stuff going. You have Amplified Snow Flurry, which lets you discount your hero power. And yeah, you have Rune of the Archmage. You could cheat out with your Clumsy Courier to get like basically Puzzle Box, depending. It could be on turn 7, turn 6 with the coin. And you got Mordresh and the new hero card, Magister Dawngrass. So very hero power based. You have defensive tools in here. Looks kind of cool. This one I hope works out. I doubt it will, but I hope it works out. And a lot of these cards I've had sitting in my collection forever, just collecting dust. So at least for one day, I'll at least get to try it for a little bit. Next, we have Big Paladin. Big Paladin got a lot of tools this expansion, particularly with Hold the Bridge in Cavalry Horn, basically tutoring out your big stuff. You got Lightforged Carriel, which basically gives you the immovable object, making yourself pretty, you know, allowed to live and push damage unless you get oozed. And we have the two new big boys, actually three new big boys in this deck. You got Brasswing, you got Templar Captain, and Lokolar the Ice Lord. So a lot of new big boys to cheat out with your commencement and all that other stuff. Looks solid, looks interesting. probably not amazing, but again, we'll give it a try. And Lifeforge Carryall just looks ridiculous. Like, she can go into any deck. It doesn't matter. It can go into any deck, so gonna be pretty good there. Next, we have like a Nazoth Control Priest archetype thing going on here. Nazoth Deathrattle Priest with Zarella, the new hero card, which activates your Deathrattle effects, which is like, you got Moarg Forge Fiend, Undying Disciple, Light Shower Elemental, Spirit Guide, which draws you some cards, and you can mana cheat with Vandar Stormpike, discounting everything, and also get another Resurrect Bomb with Amulet of Undying. Seems pretty slow, seems kind of vulnerable, but it does have that Control Priest feel to it, and it's not just infinite RNG, which I like. You still have Palm Reading and Renew, but not the Raise Dead and Wandmaker Scorpid stuff, so I'm looking forward to trying out some Priest. I know I just said that and I'll regret it, but you know, we're gonna do it for expansion times, right? Expansion launch. Next is a deck I also think that won't be great, but I have to try it, is Tempo Burgle Rogue. It's got basically the whole Maestra pack, Maestra of the Masquerade, trying to make that useful by you're as another class and all of your Burgle cards are active until you play a rogue specific card. You have like Double Agent, which you could play as your first card, 3 mana 6/6, or you could just play Swashburglar into Double Agent. We have the new Cold Tooth Yeti, just good tempo card, and the deck also has an OTK win condition. You have Scabs, the new hero card, combined with Mr. Smite and Shadow Steps, basically old Leroy OTK, where you can discount your Smite, Shadow Step, do some pretty crazy stuff. You also got Tenwu in there. So it's a Burgle mixed with like actual tempo and aggro win condition. So I feel like it's got a shot and I gotta try it, even if it's a complete disaster. Quest Rogue and Garrote Rogue are probably the ways to go, but those are the same decks as before. Next, we gotta go with Shaman. We gotta go Free Shaman. We gotta go in on Free Shaman. It's got a bunch of insane looking cards. Wind Chill looks crazy. Baron Glacier looks crazy. Snowfall Guardian looks nuts. Like, a lot of these, and Frostbite on top of that. It just looks like it has real potential. You also have Brukan, the new hero card, and Free Shaman definitely has a shot, and I'm looking forward to spamming some Free Shaman. Should be pretty cool. Yeah, I did it. I don't regret it. I don't regret the pun at all. I'm gonna do it. Next, we have the most ambitious of the Warlock decks, the Humongous Owl OTK deck, where basically you want to kill your Humongous Owl, and then you go in on Tamsman's Phylactery and play a full board of Wicked Shipments, kill them off, and destroy your opponent with a bunch of 8 damage procs. I feel like Quest Warlock's just gonna be better, but hey, we're gonna give it a shot. You got Dreadlich. I said Dreadlich last time. I heard a lot about it. It's Dreadlich Tamsin, just an insane hero card that clears the board, gets you better hero power armor. Just insane. Really good card. And yeah, we'll give this a shot. It looks pretty degenerate. We'll see if it works out. But yeah, some Owl OTK Warlock will be in store. And lastly, we have the Warrior deck of choice here, which is Rakara's big Warrior deck. Rakara, the new hero card, gives you weapon reach with your hero power, as well as basically Justicar if you get an honorable kill. And we have some new additions to the deck, like Shield Shatter, just incredible board clear. And that's pretty much it. The bad guy's Frozen Buckler as well. Not a ton of new stuff in here. Warrior got a lot of weird stuff, like taunt stuff I don't see working out, but I think Big Warrior's got a good shot, and I think Rakara fits in very well there. So there you go. Those are 10 decks you can try on day one. Again, all the deck codes are in the description below. You can also check out the Vicious Syndicate article for more theory crafts. You can check out other YouTubers. Funky Monkey always has an amazing theory craft video, like a bunch of decks you can try out. I recommend looking for his YouTube channel, subbing to him if you haven't already, or whoever else you can think of. You can feel free to share in the comments below, and hopefully I'll see you on stream later today, or if you're watching this right now, I might be live right now. Come check. It might be time. Anyways, have a great day and stay salty, my friends.